The idea that only a Jedi can use the Force to return past death has been an idea that was introduced long ago. In Star Wars canon, for some time, it's been stated that again, only a light side Force wielder can ever discover this power, as it is only through the release of self that one finds eternal life after death. Eternal life, the ultimate goal of the Sith. Yet, they can never achieve it. It comes only through the release of self, not the exaltation of self. It comes through compassion, not greed. Love is the answer to the darkness. In Legends, there's more description on how a Jedi Force ghost actually operates. This comes from the voice of an ancient Jedi. "I was able to touch you because we are connected by the Force. I drew on your link with the Force to become more solid, just as I draw on it now to become visible to you." Again, for several years in Star Wars canon, we believed that it was impossible for a Sith Lord to become a Force ghost, and to return past their physical death. Something, though, that was later retconned with the Sith Lord Mommen, and even later down the line with the return of Emperor Palpatine in The Rise of Skywalker. The first two individuals that we knew of in Star Wars canon that were dark side wielders that returned past the deaths of their physical bodies. Emperor Palpatine transferred his essence into a clone body of himself, but Mommen is more interesting. However, the main focus of this video will be on the Grand Inquisitor, who we also recently learned returned past death. However, the Grand Inquisitor is more unique. As we know, this was not willingly done, as it was literally Vader himself that bound him to the physical world. And although we haven't received a clear explanation as to how in Star Wars canon, we do have one for Legends. But first, let's talk about the Sith Lord Mommen and how he was able to achieve it. Again, this being a canon source. Upon Mommen's death, he managed to actually transfer his very spirit within his mask. Similarly, but quite different to what Emperor Palpatine would do with his clone body. Mommen was very much alive within his mask, and he could even possess people that wore it. The same thing would happen to the Grand Inquisitor. However, instead of his spirit being placed within a mask, it was placed within a location. A High Republic outpost, in fact, meant to be a trap for Jedi placed by Darth Vader. The Wikipedia on Sith ghosts says this: "Certain Sith lords had also discovered similar techniques to the Jedi as returning post-physical death. Occasionally, their bodies would fade as Jedi would. Though like the Jedi, this was not a prerequisite to becoming a Force ghost. It was not uncommon for the spirits of Sith lords to remain in the physical world, bound to the world through an object, location, or simply due to the Force and their malice and hatred. Unlike the Jedi, however, the Sith found little peace in this form, instead existing for restless centuries, eventually driven insane by solitude, memories, or dark side inflicted madness, an eternal state of purgatory. In many ways, these techniques differed from those taught by the Jedi, the most distinct difference being that the user's limited ability to interact with his surroundings. One proficient Sith user of this technique was Exar Kun. It should be stated clearly, however, that these Sith lords did not possess bodies that they had in life. Notable Sith such as Darth Undedu and Darth Bane feared their own mortality rather than embracing it and becoming ghosts of the Force such as their Jedi counterparts. Due to this fact, they sought ways to escape death and live on indefinitely. Though there was much speculation, Bane's body did not disappear and become one with the Force when he died. His soul was absorbed into his apprentice's body and dominated by her soul, leaving behind only the traces of his. In this case, and many others, the Sith lived on only in small essence of their souls that they embedded into the Sith holocrons that they had created during life. Whereas the many Jedi who believed that there was no death, only the Force, lived on forever through the acceptance of their death. The Sith believed that the Force would free them and break their chains that bound them to their mortal selves. However, this was ultimately proven incorrect, as even the most powerful of Sith lords were never able to achieve what a Jedi could through the release of self. This is now hugely significant to Star Wars canon, as again stated previously, it was not possible in canon for a Sith to return post-death. However, this has now been retconned, with again the three most notable being Mommen, the Grand Inquisitor, and Emperor Palpatine. All very different, however. Emperor Palpatine, as I stated, transferred his essence into a clone body. Mommen transferred his essence into a mask, and the essence of the Grand Inquisitor was forcefully implanted within a High Republic outpost. Out of all of these, I find the Grand Inquisitor's to be the most interesting. It's clear that he does not want to be in this state, but that the Sith are aware of it, and the individuals like Darth Vader are also aware of it. Emperor Palpatine and Darth Vader both refuse to use this technique, with Palpatine discovering a different technique to return past death, and Vader choosing not to bind his spirit to a location or an item. This gives a very clear idea that the state that the Grand Inquisitor is in is very much a place of purgatory. When we see him, he's even still engulfed in the flames of the Sovereign. What I find most unique about the Grand Inquisitor, though, is it's clear he can still interact with the physical world, as himself and Luke have a lightsaber duel. It's unclear, however, whether this lightsaber is simply a manifestation of the Force, and whether or not Luke Skywalker was simply dueling the Force energy of the Grand Inquisitor, which is what I speculate. Again, I think that the very body, as well as the lightsaber of the Grand Inquisitor, was destroyed, and that what Luke is fighting is just the pure dark side energy of what existed within him within his life. I want to illustrate just how major of a change this is for Star Wars canon, as it's been stated for literally years now that a Sith cannot return past death. Now though, we know in canon, as we've seen several times before, they very much can, and does set a precedence for stories moving forward, that rules placed within the Star Wars universe that even the creators have talked about for years are subject to eventually be changed. In this case, I do think it's for the better, and I did like in Legends continuity how certain Sith ghosts return past their physical death, and the lessons that they imparted against the living. Anyway though, I would love to hear your thoughts on this. Again, be sure to check out the big sale on the Star Wars merch page, where you can find t-shirts and hoodies up to 70% off, and as low as $15. As always, my friends, thank you guys for the continued support on the YouTube channel. May the Force be with you, and have a great day.